Sport and the netball world is in a panic this morning, reportedly, with news the Collingwood Magpies are in danger of collapse. Netball Australia CEO Kelly Ryan joins us right now. Kelly, thanks for joining us this morning. Good morning to you. They are aligned, this team, with arguably Australia's biggest club in any footy code, the AFL team, of course. How has it come to this?
Yes, good morning, Alex. Look, obviously, we were informed a couple of weeks ago that Collingwood wanted to have a deeper review of what their netball program looked like in totality of their entire sports program. And at this stage, we're still awaiting the results of that review, which will happen in due course. But at the end of the day, we have an incredibly strong competition. It's the best competition in the world. And we know that we'll have eight teams participating in that competition when 2024 rolls around.
OK, well, Collingwood, they've got the lowest attendance in the country. They're the bottom of the ladder. What's going on there? Why can't they get this together?
Yeah, look, that's a question for Collingwood, really, in terms of how they're building their crowds and how they're building their fan base when it comes to building their netball program. So obviously they're having a good look at all of those metrics in totality, as are we. And at the end of the day, when they've completed their review, we'll work really closely with them on what the outcome is in that review. But netball in totality is still really strong in this state, and we look forward to having two teams in this state as of next year.
Yeah, you say that, but it's been pretty tough financially for Netball Australia lately. Is it up to the Victorian government to step in and help?
Look, it's up to ourselves to make sure that we work our way out of the financial troubles that we have had as a result of the COVID pandemic. We'll have our AGM tomorrow, which will report that we're now making a profit as of the 2022 year. So that's a big turnaround from where we were this time last year. We were talking about deficits and now we're talking about profit. So the financial health of the sport actually is in really good shape. So that is what we'll take in good stead and make sure as we're rebuilding Super Netball that it also remains incredibly strong.
Okay, and I mean, there's other sports, soccer, cricket, that are probably taking athletes away from netball, but there's a lot of parents of netball players, a lot of young netball players watching this. How do you see the future of netball in this country?
The future of netball is going unbelievably well. We've just received our latest participation results, which has over 1 million people playing netball across the country. So we're now the third largest participation sport in totality now, above the AFL. So when you talk about the health of the sport more broadly, it is incredibly strong. So we don't have any concerns about the future of netball in any way, shape or form. What we're talking about is a review of one of the teams in the Suncorp Super Netball competition. But at the end of the day, we will have eight really strong teams in Suncorp Super Netball as of the next season. And if that's Collingwood, that's Collingwood. If it's another team, then that's what we'll obviously work through.
Okay, let's hope the Pies can turn it around. Kelly Ryan, thanks so much for being with us this morning.